It's time now for the award-winning number one local talk show in Northeast Pennsylvania, The Sam Lesante Show. Now here's your host, Sam Lesante.
Thanks for joining me on The Sam Lesante Show, folks. I'm Sam Lesante. Folks, let's have fun. Let's have fun this next half hour. It's a light show. It's going to be a fun show. You'll notice I have a lot of pictures all around me, but it's going to be a fun show. You know, and if you like cars and if you like people who do a lot of great things for people, this is a great show to watch. My friend Jerry Enders is with me today. Normally I'm down there in Pottsville, and we're in front of his museum, Jerry's museum, and we have a great time. But this year is something special. So I asked Jerry to come on the show so we could start it off with a lot of reminiscing. This year it's the 25th anniversary of the Great Pottsville Cruise. Now, folks, this affects probably the state of Pennsylvania. I mean, well, definitely northeastern Pennsylvania. To give you an idea how this cruise, it started in 1994. It was originated by the Pottsville Pride. It had four original members: Bill Moran, Bill Klein, Roy Eiler, and of course Jerry Enders. The cruise is expected to have 90 participating cars. They ended up about 360 cars. This is 1994. The second year, 1,200 cars. The third year, 1,600 cars. Then it went to 2,200 cars, and it just keeps growing and growing. Jerry, thanks for coming on the show.
Hey, Sam, great to be here, and I'll tell you, I wouldn't miss it for anything getting this new cup. I love
the
you, Sam.
Sam. Cup,
yeah. Yep, Sam, you always take care of your guests.
Yeah. Well, let me tell you, we have a lot of fun together.
Oh, I mean, absolutely.
Throughout the years, I cannot believe, Sammy was telling me, 2004 is when we did the first actual taping of the cruise, okay? And you know how much I love the people in the greater Pottsville area. I mean, we've been
absolutely
there since the lasting legacy and working with all those people. This cruise affects everyone. So going back, I see you were one of the originators.
Right. Yeah. Actually, Sam, I even brought a picture when I was thinner and had a lot more hair.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm going to hold this up. But
okay, let me see.
Was the picture, Sam.
Oh, my gosh. Girls, watch out.
That was from the... That, this Sam, was from the first cruise that the newspaper did a story.
Yeah.
And I still have that 66 Dodge Coronet, which you and Sammy have ridden in.
Yeah.
That was the red car that we did all the filming, Sam.
Yeah.
Every year, you'd hop in the back of that and
we'd have
the camera. We had a ball.
Yeah. Oh, let's go back to 1994. Okay. How did this cruise originate?
Well, Pottsville wanted to put something together, Pottsville Pride, to create an event in Pottsville. They wanted to create an event, have something to go on downtown, and start doing events downtown. And a couple of guys there at a ball game or something got talking on the bleachers, and I had a car show at the dealership down at Jerry's Northeast Auto Sales. I want to throw a plug in there, Sam. And we had a car show, and a lot of people got talking, hey, this is pretty good. And I always loved classic cars, but these guys got together, Charlie and Roy and them, and Bill Klein, and said, well, why don't we do a little car cruise? So then they called me, having classic cars, and being a car enthusiast, they gave me a call and said, hey, you want to get involved? Bring your car out and help out. That's how it started, just to have an event, not to raise money or anything, just a fun night. So for 3 years, it was on a Wednesday night, Sam. And it was just a fun night, and people started lining the streets, waiting for the cars to roll at 6 o'clock. And it got to be that popular, said, hey, we got to move this. So they decided to go to a Saturday and then a Sunday, because Saturday would tie up the businesses if you closed the streets. So they ended up going on a Sunday, but the original cruises would end down at Union Street Station. As you know, Sam, is where they built the new bus station and all. And thousands of people, there's pictures here, would crowd in there after the cruise for the band, the food, the flame throwing. So that's how it originally started. It was just an idea to do something in the middle of summer.
So what happens is this thing evolves, okay? So the Lions Club, of course, is the principal sponsor of the cruise, correct?
Well, what had happened there, Sam, it got to be that big. Now we wanted it to become a fundraiser. So we went to the Lions Club, and that's how I became a Lions Club member 20 some years ago. And we went to the Lions Club, we needed the help. We needed a nonprofit, a 501c3, and said, why don't you take over the ownership of the cruise? Mm-hmm. And I'll stay on as chairman and help run it. Bill Klein stayed on for a couple years, and Charlie Kirshner, he stayed on because he ordered, you know, he booked all the bands and the vendors and stuff. So it was a natural fit for the Lions Club, but once the Lions Club took it over, we were able, Sam, then to really start making a good amount of money to help other charities. So it really became
a
large fundraiser.
What was that when they start getting vendors in and making money? That
well, we really started there about, I would have to say it was around 98. You know, around 98, we started getting more vendors and really turned it around into a Lions Club event. In the beginning, some churches, Boy Scouts, Girl Scout groups would vendor it, but they didn't have the resources and the volunteers. So we started hiring out to vendors, and the vendors would pay the Lions Club. So everything really fell together like a good puzzle.
Putting this together, I know, working with you for so many years, this is a challenge. I mean, this is a major challenge. Now, you're Jerry's Northeast Auto Sales, folks. He's been in it for how many years?
Been in business now about 47 years, Sam.
What they don't know, Jerry, is what you go through, okay, and the thousands of dollars you lost throughout the year in sales because you weren't there, okay?
Right.
I see the town working together, Jerry.
Right.
And I don't see, I've always said this with you, even with the mayor and the city council, I don't know if things have changed, but they work together.
Right.
You got Democrats, Republicans, but you don't have the craziness. Am I correct?
Well, correct, because the cruise was a non-political event. The cruise was owned by the Lions Club. It was a fundraiser, and everybody in town from city government down knew at the end of the day everybody benefited. The stores, the restaurants, and then looking down the list here, Sam, of $16,000-$18,000 we would give away every year to nonprofits, including Lasting Legacy, the Majestic Theater, Child Safety. We'd donate money to the police department to help with child safety. We can go down here, the library, the YMCA, Joint Veterans. We helped so many organizations, and that's what brought it all together, Sam. It wasn't about Jerry. It wasn't about Sam. It was about fundraising and the Lions Club, and that's what I was most proud of. Yeah.
And let me tell you, Jerry, that's the thing that really sparked my enthusiasm when I saw we were there a couple times. You had us cover the stories,
right?
You know, with the van, the replacement of the library van, the scholarship programs, you know, the everything, you know, that the kids' sight program, everything that the people could benefit from,
right.
Okay? And I thought that was so great. Working with Riley, I mean, Mayor Riley, I mean, the guy's a gem. I mean,
right.
I always respected him. I think he's done so much for Pottsville, and oh, you're very, very good friends with him. These things evolved, and he's been always receptive, okay, too.
And they were very supportive. Anything we needed, and Sam, you were there, and I want our audience to know that. You were there, and you know we were always told, what do you need? How do we shut the streets down? The street department, the police, everybody worked together for this event, and it put Pottsville on the map. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know anything could put them on the map. You know, Sam, over the years, when we talked to people, they were from Wyoming. You know, they were from New York, New Jersey, Delaware, Virginia. The guy came down with the Studebaker from Connecticut, stayed for 4 days.
Yeah.
Remember that orange Studebaker?
Yeah.
People came from all over. And the city would say, well, how do they know about this? Well, in the car enthusiast world, people talked.
Yeah.
But you know, Sam, we got the word out there.
Yeah.
And it became recognized nationally. That's how we had Dennis Gage there.
I'm going to talk, folks, where does Jay Leno fit into this? Where does Dennis Gage fit into this? There's a lot of memorabilia here. The pictures we have here show 25 years. But here again, it's like he said, it affects everyone in northeastern Pennsylvania. Isn't it good to have good things happening, you know, where people could get along and work and have a lot of fun? We're going to talk about all of the fun that goes along with it. This year is going to be a bonanza, I'm telling you. I don't know what they're going to do, but he'll tell me about it. The 25th annual anniversary of the Great Pottsville Cruise, August the 18th, 1 to 8 p.m. We'll be back right after these messages. Thanks for staying with us, folks. You're watching the Sam Lesante Show. Remember, folks, 24/7, sspptv.com, all the shows we produce, okay? And, of course, you can download our app. That's the thing I tell you to do, is download the app, SSPTV. You can watch all the shows anywhere in the world. And now, folks, if you have a smart TV, download YouTube, search SSPTV, and subscribe. Now you can watch, for those people who do not have cable, which you should have cable, can now watch our shows who do not have cable, but I highly recommend you get cable. My guest today, Jerry Enders. Jerry is the Pottsville Cruise, he's the advisor to the Great Pottsville Cruise. It's the 25th anniversary. It is Saturday, August the 18th, and I want to tell you, and if you're in Pottsville, folks, I want to tell you, if you're in Trick-or-Treat, or just plan, go to Jerry's Classic Car Museum, Collectibles Museum. When you get there, it's a lot of fun. We're going to do our second show there at Jerry's place. Jerry, how did Jay Leno get into this? You were telling me the story.
Well, we'll start with Jay Leno, then we'll go to Dennis. But I was out there. I was out in Auburn, Indiana, Ocean City, Maryland. Janet and I went everywhere to car shows because I wanted to learn more. If I was going to build the Great Pottsville Cruise to be huge, I had to be out and see the other big shows. And I ran into Jay Leno out in Auburn, Indiana at the big cruise auction. It's one of the largest car events of the year in the country. And I ran into Jay Leno out there, got to talk to him, and I watched him every night. And I watch you all the time too, Sam. But watched Jay and ran into him, and he was buying a Stutz. I think it was a 1920s or 30s Stutz, open roadster, and kind of an expensive car. So I was snapping pictures. There's Jay, and I'm snapping pictures. Always carried my camera, and took a lot of pictures of him, and talked to him, got some autographs and that for the museum. And later on down the road, and it would have been 2008 there, I came across a whole lot of extra photos of Jay Leno. I mailed them to him. I sent him out, wrote a little letter to him. Jay, here, I found these, in my desk. I'd like you to have them. It's when you were buying the Stutz, which he still has it today. He restored it. It's a couple of $3 million car. And I sent him the photos. And some while later, a week or so later, the phone rings at the dealership, and Janet says, Jerry, there's someone on the phone. The voice sounds familiar, but I can't make out who it is, and they just need to talk to Jerry. I pick the phone up and I say, hi, may I help you? Jerry, it's Jay Leno. How you doing? I says, great, Jay, how are you? He says, thanks for the pictures. They were great. I appreciate them. What can I do to help you with your event?
Wow.
I said, well, Jay, I said, I know I can't probably get you in here, but I said, could we do something with your show? He said, yeah, I'll send you some passes. So he sent us a bunch of passes and photos that he signed, and he signed a whole bunch of stuff for the museum, of course, and sent it for the museum, but he sent stuff for the cruise. So we raffled off tickets to the Jay Leno Tonight Show, backstage, free admission, everything, and that's how he helped me out. He sent me T-shirts with the chin signed, and so that's how I got to talk to Jay Leno. But it's going to the events and meeting people, yeah. And that was pretty cool.
Well, then, you had Dennis Gage, okay?
Right.
So how did that evolve? How did that happen?
Same way.
Yeah.
Watch him on
TV. Get around, don't you, Jerry?
Yes. Yeah, Janet and I did a lot of traveling to car shows. You know, when you're in the car business and you want to go on vacation, you might as well go look at more cars.
Yeah.
But met Dennis Gage, and then we went to Ocean City, Maryland, huge car show down there in May, and met him and talked to him, made some phone calls. And then a friend of mine, this is a good story, Sam. I have a T-shirt framed and hanging in the museum. I will get there. And it was Dennis Gage, Hot August Nights, out in North Dakota. He was out there. He did a big show out there. It's called Hot August Nights. And I talked to him about coming in, and he was, just couldn't get there. And he called me up this right after Jay Leno called. And I also had booked Genevieve Chappelle for the cruise, because Dennis said, Jerry, I can't make it, I'm booked. And a little bit before the cruise, he calls, he said, Jerry, if you want me to come in, I canceled my engagement out in North Dakota, I can do your show. Fantastic. So now we have Jay Leno, Dennis Gage, and Genevieve Chappelle from California, the trifecta. Mm-hmm. It was an amazing year. Dennis came in, filmed the show, filmed it for TV.
Yeah.
It was featured on his 2009 Dennis Gage series. What a great guy. Mm-hmm. And he came in, we had t-shirts made, autographs, mm-hmm. license plates, and it just put Pottsville on the map, and it was absolutely amazing. But he goes to the radio station, and the radio station asked the question you did. Well, Dennis, how did Jerry get you here? He said, well, I had a PFA against him. He wouldn't let me alone. He even sent somebody to North Dakota to track me down, so I had no choice but to be here.
Well, first of all, I'm not surprised at all, knowing you. Okay, I'm not surprised at all. The cruise, okay, like I said, we're talking not only the city of Pottsville, but it attracts tons of people. I mean, we're looking at 10, 15, 20, 25,000 people coming and watch the cruise.
Right.
And each year, what do you have to do? And these are people that have pride of their cars. I mean,
right.
There's all kind of cars. I know when we did our cruise and we walked around in different cars, etc. What are the qualifications, or what do you do to bring a car in, or any guidelines?
There's no guidelines, except for on our brochure, we ask them to be cruise worthy, to be clean.
Okay.
We don't want muddy cars. We don't want, you know, cars that came out of a junkyard. But in today's cruising, now you have rat rods. Those are the rusty Model A's and cars that they hang all kinds of knickknacks on. And they call them rat rods, but they got a big 400 mm-hmm. cubic inch engine, and they're just wild. But just about anything, Sam, would qualify, as long as it's clean, respectful. So actually, we don't have to do much more than put it on the brochure, mm-hmm. that they have to be cruise worthy. They can be a 1910s car, or they can be a brand new Corvette or brand new Hellcat, you know, Mopar. There's anything at all that can come, but the people that come, Sam, you met them.
Oh my gosh.
Car people are super.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
One thing I'm really proud of, this is a non-political and non-alcoholic event. This is open for the community, for the town, for the car enthusiast. There's no alcohol. It's just a great event.
What was the most amount of cars you had?
The most amount, we estimated that one year, the stars lined up is all I can tell you. We didn't really have a big celebrity there that year, but we had about 1,600 cars.
Hey, I was there.
Well, yes, we did have a celebrity.
Okay.
We had
See
Sam.
What I'm talking about, folks? Fast they forget.
We had Sam. We had one of your good friends, Tom Clark.
Tom, great.
You know, some local people.
Yeah.
And then we pursued Dennis Gage and Genevieve.
So how many people was it?
But we had about 1,600 cars the one year.
Wow.
But it averaged out in 2008 about 1,200. And that is,
wow.
I mean, that wow. is an awesome show. When you look at these big events in Ocean City, Maryland, that might draw 1,500, 2,000.
Yeah.
For Pottsville,
yeah.
coming from
yeah.
8, 10 states around us, Sam, it's and every car has two people. They have the driver and the wife or the kids.
Yeah.
All that money is spent in town.
Well, you know, the businesses there, I mean, when I would go around, probably half of the people that I spoken to were staying somewhere around
right.
the area.
Hotels
so,
are full.
They're jammed. They're going to the restaurant. They're buying facilities.
Yeah.
And I think that's where the businesses, everyone benefits from it,
right.
okay? I know if I had a business,
yeah.
I'd be having some big specials those weekends when thousands of people are walking
well,
around.
Well, it took a while, Sam, but the businesses caught on, and they started putting signs out, welcome cruisers. I'll tell you, a big benefactor was Yuengling, because especially when we went to the 4 days, people would come and stay in town and tour Yuengling, and I have to thank Yuengling and Dick and Debbie and everybody there. They've been the official sponsor of the Dash Plaque. Everybody wants to save something with Yuengling, so they do the Dash Plaque, and everybody gets one that registers
yeah.
for the event. So we have a lot of great corporate sponsors, Sam, and yourself.
Let me tell you, you say Dick Yuengling has been one great supporter of his people, local mm-hmm. people. When I did the show with Jack Palance there
yep.
in his place, going back many years ago in the early 1990s. But Dick has always been there for the people. And he's just one heck of a guy. He really is.
And his daughters are there
now. Oh, they're beautiful.
The daughters are out there helping in the community. They're involved in so many organizations. So it's a good family.
Yeah. Folks, I'm talking to Jerry Enders. And Jerry Enders is the advisor, folks, of the cruise. Been doing it for many years. You can see Jerry or visit Jerry at the Jerry's Northeast Auto Sales. He's been around for many, many years, folks. So that tells you something about what kind of business he has. And of course, you got to go to Jerry's Classic Cars and Collectible Museums. It's right on Center Street. It's Jerry's Classic Cars and Collectible Museum. So when you go there, you'll understand what I'm talking about. We come back, we're going to talk about what's happening this year for the cruise, and it is on a Saturday, August the 18th. We'll be back right after this. Thanks for staying with us, folks. It's a fun show. We're talking to Jerry Enders, who is the advisor for representing the Pottsville Lions Club, the 25th anniversary of the Great Pottsville Cruise. And it is the Great Pottsville Cruise. Saturday, August the 18th. Jerry, what do we have to look forward to this year?
Well, Sam, it's going to kick off Saturday morning about 11 o'clock at the Car Museum, South Center Street. We're going to start with the early registration and what we're calling the deal at the museum. That is the pre-cruise show. That's the preview. We're going to preview the cars. People just cruise in, get their cruise packet. They get their dash plaque, their pin, their sticker, $20 registration. They're going to hang out there. They can leave, go cruise around town, come back. But at 4 o'clock, we're going to do an organized cruise through town like we used to do years ago. So from 4 to 5, people can bumper to bumper and cruise through Pottsville out to the West End. We have a cruise route all picked out that was set up by our, you know, city police for safety.
Good.
We're going to cruise till 5, and then everybody shows up downtown on North Center Street by, the area down there. And that's where we're going to have the evening car show. We're going to have the 50-50 drawing, the raffle prizes. And, Sam, we got rock and roll back. Shake, Rattling Souls back. We got the sponsor of Schuylkill County Visitors Bureau and the Schuylkill Valley Corvette Club helped to sponsor the band. So we got good old rock and roll, great cars, and a lot of fun going on. Now, Sam, one other thing. It ends at 8 o'clock downtown, and then they can go to the lodge out at Sharp Mountain, and we're going to have a sock hop that night from 9 to midnight.
So you're bringing it back.
Bringing back the sock hop. Same day.
I'm telling you, it's a lot of fun. So, Jerry, for people who want to come down, do they have to get tickets, or how does that work?
It's free for spectators. Just come. It's always been free for spectators.
Okay.
If you're going to cruise, you're going to have your car in there. It's a $20 registration fee.
If you want your
car. But spectators, the museum will be a special rate that day. We discount the rate to tour the museum. Last year, Sam, Cruise Day, we had over 100 and some people toured museum, had a ball. There's going to be the hot dog stand, the Lions Club, a lot of good stuff going on. It is so much fun, and you get to talk to all the people with the cars and learn something.
It is really a treat. It's a wonderful day. A lot of parking, folks. I mean, they'll park you well. He's talking about Jerry's Classic Cars and Collectibles Museum, and that's right on Center Street. South Center Street. And of course, he has his own Jerry's Northeast Auto Sales. Been there for many, many, many years. Jerry, it's so nice to have you on the show.
Sam, it's great to be back. It's fun. You know, Sam, we did so much together in the past. This is great.
Yes.
Hey, love being here.
My pleasure.
You're a fantastic help for the community, Sam. We appreciate everything you do.
Folks, put it on your calendar. It's August the 18th. It is Saturday, and it starts at 1 o'clock, but it's a great day. We'll see you next time.